I will, but I want to say this. I will not allow this. But I think Mr. Grewal,
yes.
Mr. Grewal, you advise.
I 100% agree with you that it's a sad act which should not happen.
No, I am not into expressions of sadness.
It's right.
No, I am not. I'm sorry, Mr. Grewal. I believe that in journalism,
that if there is a about 20 minutes.
Mr. Grewal, 1 minute. This whole business that we are very sad in today's India, yes, means nothing. People are sick and tired after these murders happened.
For people
to come and say, we are very sad, we empathize, we are very sorry, we'll pay a certain amount of money as token. What amount of money will bring back that man's life? Yes, Kirti.
The Punjab government should immediately put in place certain guidelines which even the Supreme Court has issued. He won't let me speak. He's going on and on.
One at a time, gentlemen.
Happens which creates a situation.
I don't know what to say.
Mr. Goswami.
It is a sad incident.
No.
It has been condemned.
Sir, I don't want a condemnation. What is a condemnation worth?
Total death.
So what is a condemnation worth?
See, once an incident has happened, the only thing
is we follow up action.
Is there any delay on our part? Answer is no. Is there any concession given to the accused? Answer is no. The thing is that it has happened. And what the government is expected to do, the government has done more than it was expected.
Mr. Grewal, what do you mean the government has done more than it should? What do you mean the government has done more than it should? Are you elected to power? Mr. Grewal, one simple question. Are you elected to power? Are you elected to power so that your minions, are you elected to power so that your party stooges? And their stooges can have a free ride.
Yes,
I am not asking of what you have done after the incident. I am asking you how was this incident allowed to happen, Mr. Grewal?
Yes, exactly.
Irrespective of the fact,
irrespective of the fact,
who is the killer, the party to who he belongs, to the caste he belongs, is immaterial. The law is equal for everybody and law is bound to take its course.
No.
And the justice shall be delivered to the guild.
Sir,
the government knows its responsibility. Allow me to complete.
Wait,
I am sorry to say that such sad incidents happened. The Congress politicalizes it. Instead of giving assistance to the state for the peace, for law and order, they just try to make out of it. That the government,
sir, two
is
things
not
we should not say. My sincere advice to you is, one, don't say politicize, because if a politician is involved and if somebody asks questions, you can't call it politics. Second is, for a long time Mr. Grewal, let me tell you something.
He joined 2 months back from Congress. Unfortunately, we allow him to join, and had he been a congressman, it would have been, the things would have been.
Sir, 1 minute. What are you saying?
So now they have
what are you saying?
To do everything for women.
Mr. Grewal, you say this person has joined from the Congress. Now somebody can turn around and say that the moment you join a ruling party.
Yes, on 1st of September.
Yeah, so the moment you join a ruling party, power goes to your head.
Mr. Grewal,
take the tough questions, because for a very long time in this country, these stories have remained hidden on the inside pages. And whenever any media, if they have taken up these cases, politicians got away with the standard thing, media sensationalized. I would say today that if there is a story that one needs to focus and if required sensationalized to put up the truth, it is this story. Because this is happening all over the place. And Mr. Jakhar, with all respect to you.
Absolutely.
Okay, Sumit, you represented Vikas Yadav, didn't you?
Yes. No, I'll come to that case. I'll need to contribute on this particular topic.
No, but put it in the context of Vikas Yadav.
We need not concentrate on the specifics of this case. No, what is more relevant is that the root cause of this case and many such cases all over the country is that the government is too liberal in grant of licenses for firearms. In case the government implements and earnestly implements the provisions of Arms Act 1959 in its letter and spirit, many of such cases will be
Sumit, as somebody, I'm sorry, it will be very direct with you. As somebody who has represented Vikas Yadav, who has been accused of being on the...
I will not allow you
to make this a debate on some Firearms Act. This is not a debate on the Firearms Act. This is about political arrogance.
What I am saying is we need to concentrate on the core issue.
No, don't define the core issue for me. I know what is the core issue. The core issue is political arrogance. The core issue is political arrogance.
Political arrogance as well as patronage by the government.
The same kind of political arrogance that your client Vikas Yadav has shown.
No, Vikas Yadav has not used any firearm. It is a case of circumstantial evidence where three persons are involved and there is a single hammer blow and the postmortem doctor in the court deposes that the injury is not... there is a less possibility
what are you
for
saying?
The injury to be caused
you
by
are not
hammer.
Aware of what Neelam Kathara has said and the evidence she has shown again and again to prove that Vikas Yadav gets special treatment while being in jail?
Vikas Yadav's appeal is pending in the High Court. The hearing is going on a day-to-day basis in the High Court. So we need not further comment on this. It's a matter of subjudice.
No, don't.
All I'm stating is Vikas has nothing to do with the current situation.
The problem is...
to concentrate on the problem at
the
hand.
The problem is there will be some other media perhaps where you can get away by making a general point. I only believe in being specific. And I'm telling you today, don't forget the manner in which Nitish Kathara was murdered in the early hours of the 17th of February 2002, Sumit. And don't forget that the case in which you are representing Vikas Yadav is a clear instance, 1 minute, of the clout that politicians and their kin enjoy. And don't forget, Sumit, that despite being sentenced to life imprisonment, your client has been in and out of Tihar jail as many as 66 times since his conviction in 2008. 66 times.
The High Court has called for records. The under High Court order, a medical board was constituted, which has given a finding that he is unwell and therefore he was being taken to AIIMS for all those treatments.
Sumit Verma, too much has happened. Too much has happened. And now everything is going to be questioned by the people of this country. That's the point tonight.
But
I want to get Neelam Krishnamurthy into the debate. Neelam Krishnamurthy, you have seen what happened. You have suffered yourself. You know what happened in Punjab today. What would you say? Why is this happening? Why is a policeman getting killed by a politician in the way that he was?
Adab, the basic reason why this is happening is because the politicians sitting here and all the high and mighty people in this country know that the criminal justice system in this country takes decades. And they can get away by shooting people, they can get away by killing yours and my children, but they will not go behind bars, that's for sure. Because they know this takes years and years, and the reason for this is because the government of India doesn't want to do anything about it. Today is a day when the government has brought in FDI. I would ask the government to please also follow the criminal justice system of the US, where even a Rajat Gupta is not spared and conviction is done very much within a stipulated period of time. So I would sincerely request...
I'd like to say something.
Let them bring in a speedy trial. Within any case it may be, it should not take more than 2 years. So that's one of the reasons why we see all these killings happening.
Well, we have to look at the bigger picture. But before I go to the bigger picture, I want to give one opportunity to Sunil Kumar Jakhar. Because he wanted to respond to what Mr. Grewal said. Now, Mr. Jakhar, let me also say the Congress track record is not fantastic. No political party in India can say today that arrogance has not gone to our head and our people have not indulged in this kind of gun culture. You are aware of that, but you can make your point to Mr. Grewal. And then I have a few questions for you as well.
Yes, please.
Mr. Goswami, I can understand Mr. Garewal not taking the moral responsibility for what has happened there. I'm not even surprised for that. What is really surprising and shocking to me is that a senior politician, a statesman, so-called statesman politician, who made the governor read an address written by his own government calling him a saint politician, has not come forth and expressed at least some sort of a reaction.
Who are you talking about?
Mr. Prakash Singh Badal.
Mr. Badal,
with all due respect to his seniority,
he has already issued a statement and it's in the press.
He went ahead and tried to condone the abduction of a 15-year-old minor girl from Faridkot. He has now deputed some minister to go and face the press. Now we have Mr. Garewal here. I wish it was Mr. Badal here trying to at least take the moral responsibility. What is happening in Punjab, Mr. Goswami, is there is a total, as if you may excuse me for saying it, Mr. Badal has lost it. He has lost the control, the grip over the administration. There are various centers of power which has emerged. And there are more de facto chief ministers running the show.
I think, Nawab, by this, saying this, is going out of the issue.
Mr. Jakhar, I will request you, Mr. Jakhar. Don't make it political, because if you make it political, then let's have a political debate. In that case, I would like to ask you, one minute. If you are making it political, then take my questions.